Negative margins allow us to move elements in the opposite direction that would usually occur when using positive margins. In this lesson, we will go over this example demonstrating negative margins using HTML and CSS. So let's go. Let's begin by creating a file named index.html. Then type an exclamation mark and press enter to make an HTML5 template. Change the title to CSS Negative Margin. Because we are only concerned about styling, we will use div elements. Start by using a div element with an ID of block underscore element underscore 1 and the content of block element 1. Now copy the div element and paste it below the current div element. Change the ID to block underscore element underscore 2 and the content to block element 2. Now right-click and choose Open with Live Server and see the results in Chrome. Next, create a file named main.css. Type asterisk followed by curly braces, then margin colon 0 semicolon, padding colon 0 semicolon. This is to clear out any margins and padding in the document. Now we will start to define the style for the elements. Now type the pound sign followed by block underscore element underscore 1 followed by curly braces. Next, we're going to make the background a light gray. Increase the font size to 35 pixels. Then center the font horizontally using text-align center. Center the text vertically by using a line height of 300 pixels. Now give the div element a width of 300 pixels and a height of 300 pixels. Choose a padding of 25 pixels. Now make the margin top, bottom, left, right, all 25 pixels. Create a border with a border style solid, a border width of 20 pixels, and a border color of black. Now copy the block element 1 styling and paste a copy below. Change the block underscore element 1 to block underscore element 2. Now let's link the CSS file to the HTML. Type link with an href of main.css and a rel of style sheet. Now looking at Chrome, we can see both the elements and their styling. Let's look at the style sheet. Let's go to block element 2 and change its top margin to 0. That way we can concentrate on block element 1 and its bottom margin. As you can see, nothing's changed visually because the top element still has a bottom margin of 25 pixels. Now go ahead and right-click on the element and choose Inspect. Now we can see the block 1 element's margin highlighted in a light orange. You can see that block element 1's bottom margin is 25 pixels. Now go back to the CSS code. Change block element 1's bottom margin to 10 pixels. Let's look at that in Chrome, and you can see that the bottom margins change slightly. Now let's go back to the CSS and change the bottom margin to 0 pixels. Now we can see that both of the elements are lined up next to each other. Now we can go back to CSS and change the bottom margin to a negative margin of negative 10 pixels. Go back to Chrome and you can see block element 2 has shifted up slightly. Now let's go back to the CSS and change the bottom margin to 50 pixels. Now go back to Chrome and you can see that the bottom element is shifted up even more. Now go to the CSS file and change the bottom margin to 150 pixels. Let's go back to Chrome and we can see that the bottom element has shifted up even more into the top element. This shows that the negative margin pushed up the block element 2 from the bottom up into the block element 1 on the top. Please note that there is an app in development that will accompany this channel. When the app is complete, there will be a link placed in the upper right corner of the page that will link to a video about the app. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the content, please subscribe to the channel. I look forward to bringing you the next lesson, and I hope you all have a wonderful day.